Hello and welcome to a new episode of Muk3D tutorial. Today we'll be looking at a very powerful features from Muk3D. It is the dynamic dams. So the dynamic dams is really a very flexible and visual approach to your initial design. You can basically do a whole lot of changes in your alignment, in your profile, in your elevation, and directly see what is the impact on your structure and on the existing site. So let's start directly with this topography that's been loaded. I'll just remove the imagery so that it's a little bit simpler to visualize. And the first step will be to create your center line for your dam. So I've gone to polyline, create a draw line, and we'll create a center line at an elevation of 100 meters. I'll just do a very quick center line. So now we've drawn our center line, and the next stage will be to draw our dam. And I will go to structures, dams, create a dam from your center line. For this initial exercise, I will not change any of the default values. So we'll build a dam with a crest width of 20 meters, a left and right slope of 1:2. I will just change slightly the shell height to make sure that the shell that we'll build will cross our topography. And then finally, and that's where the magic happens, you've got the options to create a dynamic model. So click on that. It will ask you to select your base grid. It will ask you to select your center line, and automatically you have a new window that appears. It will have some variables that can be changed about your design, and it will have some information. In this case, it gives you your dam volume. So the volume that you have within your dam, it's 2.8 million. And the footprint area of 162,000 square meters. Each of those variables are editable. So you want to change your downstream slope, you can just change your downstream slope, and automatically the slope has been adjusted, and you can see that in your visual interface. We could change the crest elevation. If you change the crest elevation, in this case, we've got the options to use the line elevation. So I will remove that. And let's say we wanted a much smaller dam at 60 meters. And that's a bit too low, 80 meters or 110 meters, for example. And you have your dam that's automatically changed. What you could also do is directly change the alignment of your dam. If you wanted to change slightly your alignment and then see how that impacts on your design, just change your center line, and then automatically your dam has been updated. So as I was saying, very powerful tool. But not only can you build your dam wall, you can actually add to this dynamic model. So in this case, we'll add a pond. We've got two type of ponds really that we can use. It's a pond by volume or a pond by elevation. In this example, we'll try to see, what is the total capacity that we can store within this dam. So we'll just do a dynamic pond with elevation. Pond name will not change it. Connect to, it will here ask you, which dynamic model you want to connect it to. So in our case, we want to connect it to this one, and just select a place where your pond is. And we can see here that at a pond elevation of 62 meters, it gives us a pond volume of 336 1,000 cubic meters. What would be interesting for us is to see what is the total capacity, for example. So because we have a crest elevation at 100 meters, we'll just look at what is our pond elevation. If we have a pond elevation at 99 meters, we've got actually a storage of 24 million cubic meters inside of your dam. Once you're satisfied with your model, you might want to save the entire model. So you could click on save directly. However, you might see, I'm going to call it tutorial model. It's just for this example, but it's probably not going to work. And it will tell you unable to save your model as some of the sources flagged have not been saved. I believe you just need to save the center line. So we'll save our center line and then save our model. And now our model has been saved. It appears here. So we could actually just get rid of all our layers. So now you can just load your model, just slide your model automatically on it. And you can, all your layers will appear. Your model is loaded and you can tweak it or change it from there. One thing that we did not discuss is there's additional files that you can export from this. So for example, you could export your brake lines and visualize actually where are my brake lines. So you've got additional layers that you can actually load that are not automatically loaded, but that might be useful for other purpose. So this is it. And don't forget to subscribe. See you next time. Cheers.